Today, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will take lecture and give discussion on the performance management system. Performance management system, how the performance management of an organization can be done. It is in the syllabus of the BBA and the MBA and the management courses. Performance management system. This is the syllabus of the performance management system. The objective of this course is to equip the students with the comprehensive knowledge and practical skills to improve their ability for the performance appraisal in the organization. How the performance appraisal in the organization can be improved. It is particularly intended for the future manager who will develop suitable strategy and policy for the performance management. What are the strategy will be there? What are the policy will be there for the performance management and conduct the performance appraisal of their subordinates? Description will be introduction to the performance management, characteristics, objectives, and principles of the performance management, performance appraisal to the performance management, challenges to the performance management. What are the different challenges to the performance management? It is necessary to know the what are the different challenges are there in an organization, from the organization side, from the management side, from the labor side, from the other side. What are the different challenges are there and how to cope up with the challenges? You can learn here in the case of the performance management system. Performance management system, objective function, characteristics of the performance management system, competency-based performance management system, electronic performance management. Performance planning, characteristics, objective, importance, and methodology, process, and barrier to the performance planning. Competency mapping, methods of the competency mapping. Performance appraisal, process, approaches, methods, and the common rating errors. Performance monitoring, characteristics, objective, importance, and process of the performance monitoring, ongoing monitoring, and the portrait development. Performance counseling, principles of the performance counseling skills, and the performance counseling for the higher job performance. Performance management implementation, bottlenecks, strategy, and the factor affecting the performance management implementation. Operationalizing change through the performance management, building and leading high performance team, organizational culture, and the performance management in an organization. How to build the high performance team? How to lead the high performance team? In an organization, the high performance team must be there. Then the growth of the organization will be feasible when the high performance team must be there. Performance management linked reward system, components, its linkage, and implications. Ethics in the performance management. What are the principles of the performance management? What are the ethical issues? And what are the dilemmas in the performance management? It is knowing that the what are the different dilemmas are there, where, what are the developing codes of the ethics and performance management in the multinational company. Role of the HR professionals in the performance management system. Appraising HR human resource function. Future role of the HR professional in the performance management in the knowledge millennium. The contents are divided in the 14 units. Unit 1, introduction to the performance management. Unit 2, performance management system. Unit 3, performance planning. Unit 4, competency mapping. Unit 5, performance appraisal. Unit 6, method of the performance appraisal, how the performance appraisal of an employee should be done. Unit 7, performance monitoring. Unit 8, mentoring and the coaching, how the mentoring and coaching of the people is to be done. Unit 9, performance counseling. Unit 10, performance management implementation. Unit 11, organization change through the performance management. Unit 11, organization change through the performance management. Unit 12, performance management linked reward system. Unit 13, ethics in performance management. What are the ethics in the performance management system is there? Unit 14, role of the HR professional in the performance management. What are the role of the HR in the professional in the performance management system is there? These are divided into the 14 units. Unit 1st, introduction to the performance management. The contents, objectives, and the concept of the performance is there. Concept of the performance management, characteristics of the performance management, objectives of the performance management, principles of the performance management, performance appraisal of the performance management, challenges to the performance management, and the summary is given there. Keywords is there and there. Self-assessment is there. Review questions is there. Then the further reading is given there. This is the about the performance management. After studying this unit, you will be able to explain the meaning and characteristics of the performance management. State the objective and principles of the performance management. Discuss performance appraisal to the performance management. State the challenges to the performance management. The power of organization is increasingly linked to its intellectual capital rather than its physical assets. Any of the power of the organization is linked to the intellectual capital of the people. What are the intellectual capital of the people is there? It is more linked with the intellectual capital rather than its physical assets, People are now the drivers of the corporate performance and competitiveness. Therefore, performance management deals with the improving organizational performance by improving employee performance. Essentially, the cost of the competitiveness involves efficiency and productivity. Dr. Mitrunjay Acharya observed that the workforce productivity constitute around 60% of the total cost. And 60% of the total cost constitute with the workforce productivity. Therefore, the growing significance of the performance management needs no further emphasis. Concept of the performance. Organization have to compete for the survival. Every company are competing for the survival. It is survival of the fittest in the true sense of the term. Survival to the fittest in the true sense of the sense. Performance is the only way to do that. An ordinary performance will not do. Even better performance may not be adequate. It is has to be necessary the best in order to compete and thrive. Performance defined. The Oxford English Dictionary defines performance as behavior, the way in which the organization, teams, and individual get work done. Campbell believes that the performance is behavior and should be distinguished from the outcomes because they can be contaminated by the system factors. A more comprehensive view of the performance is achieved if it is defined as embracing both behavior and outcome. This is well put by the Broombrush 1998. Performance means the both behaviors and the results. Behavior emanate from the performance and the transform performance from the abstraction to the action. not just the instrument for the results. Behavior are also outcomes in their own right. The product or metal and the physical effort applied to the task and can be judged apart from the results. Performance could therefore be regarded as the behavior, the way in which the organization, teams, and the individual get work done. This is the performance in which the organization, teams, and the individual get work done. Compel believes that the performance is behavior and should be distinguished from the outcome because they can be contaminated by the system factors. Performance means a skill to do plus will to do. Creating skill to do, it means resources and infrastructure required for the performance. There are mainly machine, money, material, and the main. Four M is there. They determine the capacity of an organizer. Better performance cannot be thought of without the state of the art machinery superior to or equal to the computer. Paucity or inferiority of the money or material will be definitely hamper the performance. Hence, their strategic availability is the must. Men, the most critical and scarce of the all the resources are not only most important as also most strategic. Sourcing, extracting, developing, retaining, and motivating talent are the most crucial jobs of a performing organization. The pillars of the human performance. Work performance of an individual may be observed and appraised along three dimensions as follows. An understanding of the context of the work or the work situation in terms of its purpose, nature, conditions, requirement, metrics of the appraisal, and so on. The ability to carry out the work effectively in terms of the requisite knowledge, skills, and capability required for the performance excellence and the motivation to carry out the work in terms of the one's commitment and waste efforts towards excelling in performance. These three dimensions may be viewed as three pillars of the human performance, these understanding the concept, the ability to be effective, and motivational to the excel. These three axes of the human performance may be logically applied and instant to exploit the nature, norms, and attributes of the human capital as follows. The first pillar, understanding the context, implies reflective and critical understanding of the dynamic business environment of their enterprise. It also implies comprehension of their company's vision and strategy, business system design and profit model, competitive logic, and the core value proposition. More importantly, it implies clarity of the understanding regarding their company's processes and the mechanism for the creation, capture, and delivery of the value, and the nature and rationale of their individual and collective efforts toward realizing their company's vision and strategy. The implied awareness and understanding of their company's business context also orients them towards a better appreciation of the present and potential challenges facing their company and the requirement of the knowledge, skills, and capability for coping with them. The second pillar are the ability to be effective in the context of the human capital implies evident dedication to work excellence in their broadly defined and non-rigid work roles. More importantly, it implies sustained orientation towards learning, upgradation of their skills, cultivation of the new and needed capability, expertise, creative thinking, and use of the knowledge for both problem solving and innovation. Streamlining of process, procedure, and routines for eliminating non-value-adding activity and experimentation and initiative in search of the opportunity. This is so for the concept of the performance excellence or effectiveness is neither static nor fixed. The second pillar is meaningly shaped by the first, understanding the business context in terms of the adaptability of the human capital to changes in a firm's business environment. The requirement of the learning, knowledge, skills, and capability and of by employee and the life cycle of its organization and industry. The requirement of the employee's effectively performance would be radically different across disparate organizations like high technology growth firms. Firms in mature or declining industry or firms caught in industrial shakeout and consolidation. Even for the same firm, requirement to differ from time to time depending upon changes in its competitive situation. The focus of the human capital along the second axis of the performance is on the productive learning, development, and use of the knowledge for the customer value work excellence. The third pillar is the motivation to excel, implies an organization-wide shared ethos of the high degree of the commitment to enterprise goals and a high level of the cooperation among the employee towards working together to achieve these goals. These in turn imply a high level of the trust and the goodwill among the employee in pursuit of the shared objective. Both commitment and cooperation are vital for the individual with the complementary and the specialized knowledge and skills to collaborate creativity for solving difficult problems, developing new products and services, achieving performance breakthroughs, creating new competency, and generating value through the relentless improvement and innovation. Employee in an enterprise, both individually and collectively, must score high on each of these three axes and constantly across all the three axes and in an extending manner over time. In order to constitute the firm's human capital, the ability to meet the foregoing requirement of the performance in a continuing manner raises a basic question. What type of the person would be capable of scaling the heights of the performance and sustaining the same in a steady state function over time? Performance excellence and effectiveness in organization apart from an individual's ability and motivation depend primarily on the individual's ability to effectively collaborate with others. Collaboration is a purposive relationship based on the trust, mutual regard, and sharing of the idea, information, knowledge, resources, and the responsibility. It involves working together to learn, solve problems, innovate, meet tight time schedule, cope with the obstacles, deal with the unforeseen difficulty, and strive to achieve and exceed organizational goals every day. The nature and the range of the collaborative activity may vary. The collaborating person or the team member may be different from time to time, and job rotation assignment may engender new forms and modes of the interpersonal and group interaction across the organizational levels, space and time. But the imperative of doing one's best in cooperation with the others, helping others when needed, and pursuing stage goals of the enterprise remain unchanged. The performance management cycle. The performance management is a process, not an event. It operates as a continuous cycle as shown in the figure. Plan, act, monitor, and review. This is the performance management cycle. Plan, act, monitor, and review. This is the performance management cycle. Concept of the performance management. The concept of the performance management may be categorized into two separate types of the management. The first one deals with the performance of an organization as a whole, evaluates the effectiveness of its managers. The second one deals with the system of the evaluating employee in order to enable them to achieve a reasonable goal and thus ensure that the organization performs better. Linkage of the performance management with the other subsystem: human resource planning, recruitment and the selection, industrial relations, monitoring and the counseling, reward management, training and development. Training and development, annual stock taking, performance management audit. Human resource planning, data on the job person fitment criteria, matching for the organizational effectiveness, recruitment and selection, basis for determining selection criteria, quality candidates result in the performance improvement, industrial relation, improving working relation, joint goal setting results in the improved performance. Monitoring and the counseling, developing leadership skill, employee empowerment, work-life balance, internalization of the ethic policy, reward management, identification of the talents, effective career and the succession planning, compensation management, training and development, basis for the training, needs for the identification, aids in the performance improvement, competency management. It is pertinent here to understand what performance is. Burish defines performance both as a behavior and results. Behavior emanates from the performance and transforms performance from the abstraction or action, not just the instrument for the results. Behavior also are also outcomes in their own right, the products of the mental and physical effort applied to the task and can be judged apart from the results. In the organizational context, performance means successful formulation, implementation of the value creating strategy, which either generates or sustains its competitiveness. Key ingredients of the successful performance management: committed leadership, build competency-based development plan, strong links between performance measure and the program results, transparent performance information, effective multi-source feedback mechanism to discuss and address the performance issue, useful performance measure. Hence, performance measurement helps organization in management consistent performance in a manner which holds employee and manager accountable for supporting its objective and strategy. Successfully fulfilling assigned job responsibility and accomplishing individual performance goal. This would require the following prerequisite. Business process are as simple as possible. Line of leadership and management are clear. Employees are empowered, which is an important driver of the innovation. A distinct organizational culture. Workplace interaction are based on the honesty, integrity, and trust, openness to the change. Characteristics of the performance manager. The following are the key characteristics of the performance management. Performance management is an important organizational tool to clarify the performance objective, standard, critical dimension and competencies to enhance the individual performance. Performance management works best when an employee's work is planned and goals for the achievement are communicated. It emphasizes the development of the capability and capacity of employee to perform constantly, coupled with the agility to respond to a changing dynamic business and the work environment. Performance management is a systematic and holistic approach to identify critical dimensions of the performance. It helps in integrating performance management process with other critical organization systems, including the leadership development, succession planning, and the talent management efforts. Performance management is a multidimensional concept and includes inputage, process, and output, and the outcomes. Performance management transforms organizational objective and strategy into a measurable action plan by getting the right information and to form the right people at the right time in the right format. These are the characteristics of the performance management. It is systematic and the holistic approach to identify critically the dimension of the performance. Performance management work best when an employee's work is planned and goals for the achievement are communicated. Employee's work is planned and goals are achievement are communicated. Performance management is an important organizational tool to clarify the performance objective, standards, critical dimension, and competency to enhance the individual performance. It helps in integrating performance management process with other critical organizational systems, including the leadership development, succession planning, and the talent management efforts. Performance management is a multidimensional concept and includes inputage, process, output, and outcomes. Performance management transforms organizational objective and strategy into a measurable action plan by getting the right information to and from the right people at the right time and the right format. Objectives of the performance management. The major objectives of the performance management are discussed below. To enable the employee towards the achievement of the superior standards of the work performance. To help the employee in identifying the knowledge and skill required for performing the job efficiently, as this would drive their focus towards performing the right task in the right way. Boosting the performance of the employee by encouraging employee empowerment. Motivation and implementation of an effective reward mechanism. Promoting a two-way system of communication between the supervisor and the employee for clarifying expectation about the roles and the accountability. Communicating the functional and organizational goals. Providing a regular and transparent feedback for improving employee performance and continuous coaching. These are the goals. These are the objectives. Identifying the barriers, which is most important. In the case of the company, what are the barriers are there? Identify the barriers to effective performance and resolving these barriers through the constant monitoring, coaching and development intervention. Resolve these barriers. These are the major goals of the performance management. Promoting a two-way system of the communication between the supervisor and employee for clarifying the expectation about the roles and accountability. Communicating the functional and the organizational goal. Boosting the performance of the employee by encouraging employee empowerment, motivation, and implementation of an effective reward mechanism to help the employee in identifying the knowledge and skill required for performing the job efficiently. To enable the employee towards achievement of the superior standards of the work performance. Creating a basis for the several administrative decisions, strategic planning, succession planning, promotion, and the performance-based payment. Promoting personal growth and advancement in the career of the employee by helping them in acquiring the desired knowledge and the skills. Principles of the performance management. What are the principles of the performance management are there? Some of the major principles of the performance management are as follows. Performance management is considered a process, not an event. It follows good management practice in which the continual coaching, feedback and communication are integral to the success. The performance management is primarily a communication tool to ensure the mutual understanding of the work responsibility, priority and the performance expectation. Elements for discussion and evaluation should be job specific, not generalized personality traits. The major duties and responsibility of the specific job should be defined and communicated as the first step in the process. This should be job specific. Performance standard for each major duty, responsibility should be defined and communicated. Employee involvement is encouraged in identifying major duty and defining the performance standard. Professional development should be an important component of the plan. The formal evaluation period should be long enough to allow for the full performance and to establish a history such that evaluation are fair and meaningful. 1 year is a common evaluation period. Documentation of the performance will occur as often as needed to record the continuum of the dialogue between the supervisor and employee. If formal rating are included, they should reflect the improvement's actual performance in the relation to the performance standard for that major duty. The supervisor should be evaluated on the successful administration of the plan and ongoing performance management responsibility. Training for the supervisor and employee increase and will be provided by the University Human Resource Services. Ten top performance management tips. Talk to your people often in order to head start performance management of your people. Keep formal discussion friendly and simply. be very positive and don't spend extended time on the weakness of the employee. Help employees achieve their needs. Build feedback in as a natural activity. Be honest in working relationship for everyone's benefit. Remember that the performance management is not an instrument to manage the indiscipline. Notice great performance and celebrate success. Have an uncomplicated and a time-bound system of the performance management. Learn from the mistakes. Performance appraisal to the performance management. The contemporary organizations are undergoing a transformation for coping against the changing needs of the environment and excelling in the business by building up their adaptive capability for managing change proactively. The traditional performance appraisal system did not suffice the needs of the changing scenario, as it was mainly used as a tool for the employee evaluation, in which the managers were impelled to make subjective judgment about the performance and behavior of the employee against the predetermined job standards. Performance appraisal, performance management. This is the distinction is given here. Focus is on the top-down assessment. Stress on the mutual objective setting through a process of the joint dialogue, performed annually. Continuous review are performed. Use gauge of the rating is very common. Use gauge of rating is the less common. Focus is on the traits. Focus is on the quantify objective, value and behavior. Monolithic system, flexible system, as very much linked with the pay, is not directly linked with the pay. Performance appraisal is a systematic evaluation of the present potential capability of the personnel and employee by their superiors or the professional from the outside. It is a process of estimating or judging the value, excellent quality or status of a person or the thing. It is a process of collecting, analyzing and evaluating data related to the job behavior and the results of the individuals. Traditionally, the performance appraisal were organized in a bureaucratic manner and suffered from unnecessary delay in the decision and the corruption. Performance appraisal were mostly narrowly focused and function in isolation without bearing any linkage with the overall organization vision or the goal. The side effect of the performance appraisal system was it generated skepticism amongst the manager and the employee on a new initiative of the HR. In the present scenario, the organization has shifted their focus from the performance appraisal to the performance management as a result of the international of the human resources and the globalization of the business. The function of the HRM have become far more complicated, as today the major focus of the strategic HRM practices is on the management of the talent, implementing such development program which enhance the competency of the employee. The performance management approach focuses more on the observed behavior and concrete result based on the previously established SMART objective. By adopting techniques like the management of the objective MBO, SMART objectives are established in terms of the other facts and figures, and in the entire process, the superior plays the role of the coach or a facilitator. The objectives are the mutually decided at the beginning of the performance season and serve as a standard of the performance for evaluation. In this method, the employee can offer a feedback on their contribution by filling up a self-appraisal form. Performance management is a much broader term in comparison with the performance appraisal, as it deals with a gamut of the activity which performance appraisal never dealt with. This system is a strategic and integrated approach which aims at building successful organization by developing high performance team and individual and improving the performance of the people. The process starts when a job is defined. Performance management emphasizes on front end planning instead of the looking backward, unlike performance appraisal, and the focus is on ongoing dialogue instead of the appraisal documents and the rating. Thus, performance management may be regarded as a continuous process. The use of the performance management in the best practice company is not because it is a major technique that the performance appraisal, but because it can form one of a number of integrated approach to the management of the performance. challenges to the performance management? What are the different challenges for the performance management? Some of the key challenges to the performance management are as follows: concerned with the output, the result achieved, outcomes, processes required for the reaching the results, and also the inputs, knowledge, skills, and attitude. Concerns with the measurement of the results and review of the progress in the achievement of the set target. Defining business plans in advance for shaping a successful future. Striving for the continuous improvement and continuous development by creating a learning culture and an open system. Establishing a culture of trust and mutual understanding that fosters free flow of the communication at all levels in matters such as the clarification of the expectation and sharing of the information on the core values of an organization which binds and a team together. Procedural fairness and transparency in the process of the decision making. These are the challenges. Concerned with the output, what are the results achieved, outcomes, processes required for the reaching the results, and also the inputs. Concerned with the measurement of the results. Review of the progress in the advancement of the set target. Defining business plan in advance for shaping a successful future. Striving for the continuous improvement and continuous development by creating a learning culture and open system. Continuous improvement is necessary. Striving for the continuous improvement, continuous development is necessary. Defining the business plans. What are the business plans are there in advance for shaping a successful future? Establishing a culture of the trust and mutual understanding that fosters free flow of the communication at all levels in matters such as clarification of the expectation and sharing of the information on the core values of an organization which binds in a team together. Procedure fairness and transparency in the process of the decision making. These are the challenges to the performance management. Here, a case study of the TISCO is discussed here. Tata Iron and Steel Company is discussed here. Performance management in TISCO. TISCO, a flagship company of India involved in manufacturing of the cost-effective steel, can be appreciated for their initiative in the implementation of an effective performance management framework and innovative HR practice. TISCO initiated a management restructuring program for the transforming into a high-performing and a growing organization. In the HR front, the management focused on providing the exciting career opportunity and building a team of the high-performing professionals, for which they hired McKinsey & Co. The consultant firstly started with building a lean and a flat strategic business unit with the enriched jobs, increased accountability and autonomy. A performance ethic program was also introduced for promoting young and dynamic professionals. And this was a replacement of the seniority-based promotions. A new performance management system was introduced for aligning the KPIs with the business strategy and identifying the superior performers in the organization by defining clear career paths and accountability. The rewards and the recognition were linked with the performance management system. The new measures in the direction of the performance management boosted the employee motivation and performance. The job satisfaction also improved due to the introduction of the fair and transparent reward system. These are the summary is given here. Summary is given there. Performance management deal with the improving organizational performance by the improving employee performance. The concept of the performance management may be categorized into the two separate types of the management. The first one deals with the performance of an organization as a whole and evaluates the effectiveness of its manager. The second one deals with the system of the evaluating employee in order to enable the achieve reasonable goals and thus ensure that the organization performs better. Performance management is an important organizational tool to clarify performance objective, standard, critical dimension, and competency to enhance the individual performance. Performance management is a systematic and holistic approach to identify critical dimension of the performance and to carry out activity necessary to ensure that the mission, objective, goals, vision, and value of the organization are being met in an effective and efficient manner. Performance management transforms organizational objective and strategy into the measurable action plan by getting the right information to and from the right people at the right time and in the right format. The use of the performance management in the best practice company is not because it is a better technique than the performance appraisal, but because it can form one of a number of the integrated approach to the management of the performance. Keywords are expectancy. It refers to the extent to which the person believes these efforts will lead to the first level outcome. Instrumentally, it refers to the probability attached by the individual to each possible performance outcome alternative, just as the individual previously assigned probability to the various levels of the effort leading to the different levels of the performance. Performance management, it deals with the improving organizational performance by improving the employee performance. Behaviors or action that are relevant to the goal of the organization. Balance, it means the extraction or outcome of the individual. These are the review questions are given here. Or the reading are given here. And the different sites are given here. These are about the unit first. We are discussed about the summary, performance management in TSCO, challenges of the performance management, performance appraisal to the performance management, 10 top performance management tips, principles of the performance management, objectives of the performance management, characteristics of the performance management, concept of the performance management, the performance management cycle, the pillars of the human performance defined, concept of the performance. These are defined here in this chapter of the introduction to the performance management.